This video is meant to give the briefest of summaries about 14 months before the expected release of the next World Magnetic Model, with some resources that you can use to learn more after the video. The primary components of Earth's changing magnetism are strength and pole position. This animation shows the normal movement of the poles, which held until a little over a century ago, until an acceleration began that has already seen the South Magnetic Pole leave Antarctica and the North racing to catch up across the Arctic Ocean. A century of historic meander of the poles now occurs in less than 2 years, and with that, the field strength is decreasing too, and that decrease has also been accelerating. Some basic and very conservative data can be found from the World Center for Geomagnetism, broken into 5-year blocks with the field dipole strength on the right, with a tiny change accelerating to 2 to 4 hundredths of a dipole moment each block. Now, this is harder to see in the more recent data, which goes year by year instead of every 5 years, but the trend is continuing. That bolded line in 2015 is the last official update, with the 2016 through 2020 data being the forecasted marks from back in 2015. Now, as you can see on the right, the forecast for the model going up to 2020 only has us dropping 0.02 off the dipole. Now, of course, that would be a slowdown from what we've seen in the previous years, especially with the acceleration in the last decade noted by NASA and the European Space Agency, but which is not reflected in this data. So, interestingly, they are claiming yet again, as they've done for a few predictions in a row, that a slowdown is going to occur. It hasn't happened yet, and no, it is not happening now. Perhaps you might remember this report from a few months ago. The World Magnetic Model is a collaboration of more scientists than I can count, from all over, detailing the situation and changes in Earth's magnetic field. They are supposed to be valid for 5-year periods between model updates, with the next one due out at the end of 2019. But we just blew past the red line, maximum error specification, 1 year ago, and are now seeing grid variation error way too high. They are blaming unmodeled crustal and external magnetic fields for taking reality outside of the bounds of their expectations. The official 2015 model, too erroneous for the above 55th north latitude region. Once again, the official marks, which predicted that the magnetic field reversal would slow down, are not holding. Too much deviation has occurred to make that 2015 model usable above the 55th latitudes. Now, for a full accounting of the situation and the effects this will have on our way of life, the video Energy from Space is linked for you right below this one. It is over an hour long, so the website magneticreversal.org can get you up to speed much more quickly. It's got videos and links to more information. All will be very helpful. The details on the space weather, human health, cosmic rays, weather, earthquakes, and volcanoes due to Earth's magnetic reversal can be found in that longer video. Whenever you're watching this, I'll see you in the morning for the daily update. Be safe, everyone.